Oh, Martyn, mountain bikes and mountain biking has come a heck of a long way over the years. Since those early clunkery, rigid bike days, modern day trail bikes are flipping good.
They have, and the sport has really developed with multiple disciplines, yep. Sub-genres, race series. So let's take a look at some of the biggest innovations. Now, when mountain biking started in the 1970s, the guys were using adapted cruiser bikes and road bikes. They were using coaster brakes. They had limited tyre choice back in those days, limited wheel choice. But the bikes have come a long way since then. But you know what? The suspension didn't even arrive until the 1990s.
Yes, I know, Mark. Did you know the very first sort of forks used an elastomer for its suspending and damping purposes?
Yes.
However, like a lot of great innovations, the mountain bike community weren't keen. There was some resistance, yeah. As they felt it affected the purity of the sport. Could you imagine that now? Yeah. No suspension.
Little known fact as well is that first push into the full suspension mountain bike was all about comfort and distance ridden. The idea being that it would be a smoother ride. It wasn't really about like performance on a downhill trail. So it was quite a different thing.
Wow. Suspension nowadays though, Mark, has come a heck of a long way from those elastomers. Yes, I mean, coil sprung, air sprung, different travels for different disciplines, of course.
Yeah, absolutely. Like an XC rider is going to be working with sort of 80 mil travel upwards, but those downhill riders, 200 mil of travel.
Whoa.
Unbelievable. Those bikes can seriously take some big hits. But obviously, the XC bikes, very lightweight suspension as well.
Yep.
And the performance is unbelievable. It's making a huge difference.
Yep. And all the tuning that they can do on the actual damper of the suspension unit now means that bikes have become incredibly more capable.
Similar to suspension, the braking systems have come a long way. Now, back in my day, Rich,
okay, let's go.
We used to use a thing called cantilever brakes.
Yikes.
And at the time, they seemed high tech, but man, they did not work very well. And then those things developed onto V brakes. The performance was slightly better, actually pretty good. But it wasn't until we got to disc brakes that mountain biking really took a different role in cycling to most other disciplines.
Oh, yes.
BMX and road suddenly were a long way behind us because the braking in mountain biking with disc brakes is unbelievable.
Yes, Mark, with the introduction of the disc brake came all the added benefits. Power, reliability, and all-round performance went through the roof over those early days of cantilevers and V-brakes.
Absolutely.
And it opened the door as to what mountain bikers could actually do, hitting longer, faster trails without having to worry about not stopping at the end.
Yeah, I mean, there is something to be said about that first ride on a mountain bike with a disc brake. It feels.
Yeah.
There's something about going fast, but there's something else about being able to stop quickly.
Yeah, it's also a bonus.
It feels incredible. Yeah. The power you have in your hand. Disc brakes are just definitely one of the biggest innovations in the sport. Full stop.
But there's more, Mark.
No.
Yeah, there is more. Hold your horses, because we've got the disc brake, but even that now is developing. So you've got 2-pot, 4-pot, and actually some people make 6-pot discs. That's the amount of pistons in the caliper, and rotor sizes. So where are we going to stop?
Well,
who knows?
I guess at some point we're going to get to the, and this is speculation, by the way, okay. We're going to get to the point of wireless braking.
Martyn, do you know another innovation that I think is an absolute game changer?
I've got one in mind. Do you want me to go for it?
Go on.
This one, I think it sounds so simple, and you wouldn't believe the difference it makes when you're out on the ride. It's the dropper post.
Yes, you did guess.
Yeah, the dropper post. Anyone who's ever used one will tell you it's something you must have on your mountain bike.
Because why wouldn't you?
It allows the bike to do what it's made for, to perform. Because if you've got a solid seats post, you've basically got an object in your way once you start descending.
Yes.
The dropper post solves that problem.
It does, it does. Gone are those days of sort of riding up with your solid seat post, stopping, dropping it down, getting out of the way to get to the bottom of the trail or whatever, put it back up, find where it's all straight out.
All gone.
Boom, press the button.
Yeah.
Bingo bango, that seat's down and out of the way. It's actually gone as far as changing bike design nowadays. Bikes are designed around droppers and the height of the dropper itself.
Unbelievable. You asked for innovations, well, there's one right there. Okay, this one is a broad innovation in mountain biking. It's bike parks and trail centres.
Yes. Now,
I tell you what, there's nothing like these places. It's a very different type of mountain biking to the mountain biking of the early days, but we're talking black trails, blue trails, red trails, all these graded trails, greens for the starter mountain biker to keep things easy but fun. There's so much at these things that you can enjoy that are going to make a special day for mountain biking, a place where you can learn. They're beautiful.
You're absolutely, I'm not even sure what to add to that because you've hit the nail on the head. But it, do you know what? All these trail centres mean that people, especially learners, I think this is what it's great for, can go to a good, safe environment and progress their skills and have a cup of tea at the same time.
Absolutely.
But do you know what? Bike parks have also recognised that pros need somewhere to go. So there are, you said black lines, but there's purple, like pro lines essentially. So pros can now go and improve their skills at bike parks. So bike parks are pushing it on for everybody.
And those pro lines are something to witness, aren't they?
Yeah, they are scary, Mary.
They are very, very scary. And now think of that. A little melting pot of beginners and actual pros, people wearing Red Bull helmets, that kind of pro rider, at the same place, creating an amazing community, all having amazing days. Your local bike park is definitely one of the biggest innovations near you.
Yeah, too right. Just think of Whistler.
Think of
Whistler, think of Dovey even.
Dovey Bike Park in the UK, fantastic.
Mental. Or Forest, there's so many.
There's
it's just,
so
they
many,
are a
so
great
many.
Innovation. Martin.
Oh, poor Martin.
Three of them. Gone are the days of punctures, for the best part anyway.
Yes.
Inner tubes, they seem to be a bit of a thing dying off, don't they?
They do.
Tubeless and tyre tech has come on leaps and bounds.
Yeah.
And do you know what? I think it's a pretty blooming good innovation now.
Yeah, I mean, this is a massive difference from that very early day 1970s mountain bike riding. Like I said, the tyre choice was very limited. These days, you've got compound choice. Yep. You've got size tyre choice, wheel size choice. Yeah. And the performance is radically different. And of course, tubeless. Punctures are almost a thing of the past, and you think how often we used to puncture.
Oh, it'd be
so
annoying. So annoying. Just rides ruined by constant punctures. But yes, you're right. Tire tech is insane. Things like compounds and casings mean that tubeless development has come on loads. Combine that with the sealants you use, so like the liquid latex that you put in there, which seals up. I mean, who would have said, 20 years ago, oh, I've got a hole in my tyre, don't worry, I've got a liquid that'll seal it up. That's bonkers.
Unbelievable. Yeah. And as a bit of a tangent on that as well, what about fat bike tyres? A whole genre of mountain biking was created because a new tyre was something that could suddenly be made that before would never have been possible. Would have been so heavy.
Yeah.
Would have been so heavy. But
absolutely
suddenly
insane.
We had fat bikes.
Yeah. Combine that, throw an insert in there, and you have possibly got a system that will see no more punctures again. So yeah, I think as far as other great innovations go, the whole tyre tubeless system is incredible these days.
Absolutely. Now, we all remember that mountain bike we lusted over in the 1990s with its triple chain set. Gone. That is a thing of the past, Rich. Because I want to say one thing to you, one buys.
One.
All the gears you want, but only one chainring up front. Simple, beautiful, perfect.
Clean.
How do they do it, Rich?
What happened to the front mech?
Gone.
Dead. Well, how do they do it? That is actually a great question. So, a combination of things. So, you've got new wide range cassettes at the back. So, 12, 11 or 12 speed cassettes.
Big dinner plate discs.
Exactly. Yeah. Massive, big, huge sprocket on the back. And a tiny, tiny, tiny one at the bottom as well. Means that you've got a really broad range of gears. You've got narrow, wide chainrings. So, the profile of the teeth on the chainring at the front fit exactly into the chain. So, there's less chance of the chain jumping off. And clutch mechs. Now, the clutch is basically part of the spring at the back of the mech there, which holds it really tight and a real good tension on the chain to stop it jumping off at the front. Because, of course, you haven't got a front mech there. You can get little chain guides to keep the chain on, but there's no front mech. Crazy.
So what you're saying, Rich, is over years of refinement, they've taken that overcomplicated system and just brought it back down to its simplicity, to a system that's working so well, but doing such an incredible job. Yeah. It's what makes mountain bikes.
Exactly, they basically, like you said, refined it to just what you need. Less moving parts, less complications, and less things to break. Less weight as well.
Absolutely. Some of those innovations are groundbreaking in mountain biking. They've made a huge difference, but we can all enjoy them now. Let us know in the comments down below, what's your favourite innovation in mountain biking? Yeah. What really changed the sport for you?
Yes, but that's it from us this time. I hope you've enjoyed the video. As always, thank you very much for watching. Why not give us a little bit of a thumbs up and a subscribe? That can't hurt, can it?
Can't hurt at all.
But from us for now, we're out of here. See you later, everybody.
Goodbye.